Welcome to the Order Basics tutorial video. In this video, we will cover the basics of how to place an order. First, all orders must start from a quote. So let's search for a quote to use as an example. Now that you have a quote open, let's look at the pricing tab. As you can see, there is one place order button beside each service level and their respective prices. When your customer is ready to place an order, you will need to select the correct place order button to ensure the price is set correctly. You are now in your order entry screen. Here you will use the tabs to fill in the information required to complete the order. The first tab is quote info, which is a copy of the critical data from the quote, and the quote number is a quick link back for reference. As we go through the tabs, you will find the required information is indicated by a blue asterisk. Please make sure all required fields are filled in so that your order will go out complete. Let's move through the other tabs, beginning with the pickup tab. Here you can enter the information needed to get the vehicle picked up, along with any contact information critical to the pickup. Once done there, move to the other end of the trip with the delivery tab. As you can see, the information required here is exactly the same as the pickup, but will differ in content. Next is the billing tab. Here you will enter the contact and payment information, allowing for someone else to make the payment, or you can use the copy buttons at the top to import the information from either the pickup or the delivery tab. Select a payment type. At this point, you've filled out all the required information to place an order. Once an order is saved, the system will automatically send your confirmation email along with a copy of the invoice to the customer, letting them know the order has been placed. Also, after you save, notice that several new tabs have appeared now that we've placed the order. These tabs will help you perform several additional tasks, like dispatching the order, receiving payments, attaching important files like signed carrier dispatch agreements, and give you access to additional resources. Let's take a quick look at these. The Carrier tab allows you to enter the carrier information once you've decided on a carrier for the order. To do this, you can select your carrier from the drop-down menu and the information will be automatically entered, or if the carrier isn't listed, then you can simply fill out the form. The Admin tab allows you to view information that's sensitive to your company's internal workings. The status of the order can be set to various values, allowing you to trigger events that send emails to your customers. For instance, you can have an email go out when the order status is changed to dispatched with the carrier's contact information. Here in the Actions tab, you will find buttons that allow you to view and/or print the carrier dispatch agreement and the bill of lading, fax, and email the carrier dispatch agreement. View the customer invoice and either post, update, or remove orders from the load boards. Additionally, you will find other resources such as links to maps and the FMCSA site. The Notes tab allows you to track what's happened with your order. You can add notes for your information that the customers will not see, allowing you to keep notes about sales, special conditions, and other observations. Our software also generates notes automatically whenever a change in status or other critical information is detected. Finally, in the Files tab, you can upload PDF files from your computer to attach to your orders for future reference. This concludes our introduction to the order process. Thanks for watching.